Please welcome Joumana Haddad.
Back in the 1980s, there was this girl in my scout group. Her name was Wafa, and she was different. Wafa came with a baggage. Its main component was the term Muslim, and it made her too noticeable in the eastern suburb of Beirut, where I grew up. An 11-year-old girl doesn't want to be noticed, especially not for being Muslim in a Christian neighborhood. It's not like Wafa wore a hijab or anything like that. Her outside appearance was totally similar to ours. But we knew she was not like us. We knew she wasn't one of us. We'd whisper, "She's a Muslim," as if it meant she's a serial killer or her dad is a nudist. I don't think we even knew what a Muslim was, except for not Christian, thus, in our prepackaged minds, the enemy. Wafa liked me. She told me so. One day, she even asked me, "Joumana, will you be my friend?" But I didn't like Wafa. To be more accurate, Rita, our leader, who was the proud daughter of a prominent member of a Christian militia, didn't like her. So I didn't like her either. Automatically, I didn't need to think for myself. Rita would do the thinking for me, and I'd simply follow. It didn't matter who Wafa was under her Muslim tag. It didn't matter that she was kind, outgoing, and helpful. It didn't matter that she was a great scouter. It didn't matter that she never came to our meetings without bringing delicious cookies that her mother had baked for us. Her mother was Muslim, so the cookies were Muslim too. We'd eat them, shamelessly, but without a thank you, a nod of gratitude, or a friendly gaze. We'd ignore Wafa and let her sit by herself in one corner of the room as if she had the plague. It amazes me, till this very day, how mean kids can be. Eventually, Wafa stopped coming to our Saturday morning councils. We missed the cookies, but Rita was convinced that this was a collective victory of the good over the bad. So we became convinced too. Automatically. We didn't need to think for ourselves. Our leader did the thinking for us, and we simply followed. You see, in the beginning of our lives, we're all similar to a frozen meal. We all have the basic ingredients pre-included in the packages that bear our names. I'm not talking about genes, rather about what is referred to as identity and heritage. Take me for example. Ris, Arab. Actual meaning, member of a Semitic people originally from the Arabian Peninsula and neighboring territories, inhabiting much of the Middle East and Northern Africa. Implicit meaning, not Western, thus not evolved, not modern, not open-minded, not anything positive anyone can possibly think of. Oh, and riding camels, of course. Nationality, Lebanese. Actual meaning, citizen of Lebanon, a country in Western Asia, in the Eastern Mediterranean Basin, historical home of the Phoenicians. Implicit meaning, civil war, good traders. Civil war, short memory. Civil war, volatility. Civil war, corruption. Civil war, beautiful woman. Civil war, delicious food. Civil war, party like there's no tomorrow. And civil war. Religion, Catholic. Well, to be more accurate, ex-Catholic. Actual meaning, member of the Catholic Church. Christian, Trinitarian, headed by the Bishop of Rome, aka the Pope. Implicit meaning, among other things, woman is the rib of man, and my God is the one and only true God amongst the thousands of gods that people on earth believe in. To be fair, the latter applies to almost all religions and their believers. Class, working class. Actual meaning, member of a social group that includes people who work for wages, have no riches, and earn little money. Implicit meaning, uneducated, ignorant, vulgar, trashy, no manners, no ambitions, worthless, pathetic, would do almost anything for money. Ya haram. Gender. Female. Actual meaning, member of a sex that can produce ova and bear offspring, has two X chromosomes. Implicit meaning. Irrational, emotional, gullible, weak, submissive, marriage obsessed, baby machine, kitchen goddess, drama queen. And that's not. And let's not forget the two most prominent, literally, ingredients. Tits. That is how I started my journey in life. With this and other data and their inferred cliches implied in my birth certificate. I didn't decide or shape or consciously choose any of them. I didn't need to do anything in order to earn them. They were my compulsory components, my baggage. Over the years, I gained other tags, of course. Feminist, thus man-hater and exterminator. Feminine, thus not feminist enough. Divorced, thus immoral and family breaker. Activist for freedom and against homophobia, thus depraved. And so on and so forth. But back to when I was born and what I was born with, I could honestly say that I was a byproduct, not a person, not just yet. The poetic image of the newborn portrayed as a blank page is wrong. We all come with baggage, and it is quite heavy. That first page is far from being blank. It has the name and what it symbolizes, the family and its past, the country and its history, the social class and its labels, the religious beliefs of the community and their cargo, the political convictions of the parents and their consequences, etc., etc., etc. Many don't bother to unpack. It's a mess, and it involves a lot of probing and sorting out. So they go on with their lives, being whoever mere coincidences decided they should be. They do with what they got. I did that too, for some time, until the suitcase became too hefty and too cumbersome for me to drag behind. But it didn't happen overnight. I didn't just wake up one day and decide, from now on, I will think for myself. I will question everything, everywhere, anytime, and make up my own mind about what I want to be, think, and believe. It took a lot of time, a lot of maturation, a lot of great books and wonderful writers, and a lot of alienation and opposition too. But most of all, it took a lot of horrible mistakes that I'm utterly ashamed of. Being intolerant, judging others on the basis of their labels, following instead of choosing, believing blindly instead of reasoning, wanting to belong to the crowd at any cost, instead of daring to defer at the risk of being excluded, spending 2 hours reciting the rosary before a math exam instead of studying, hating someone my mother hated, doing things only because a friend did them or a loved one would admire them. drives instead of consciousness, instincts instead of logic, wholesale instead of retail. Almost everything in our upbringing and world discourages us from thinking and choosing for ourselves. Do loyal terrorists think before committing horrible massacres to allegedly defend their God? Do loyal electors think before casting their votes for a corrupt political leader? Do loyal adults think before adopting the outdated traditions that their parents regard as sacred? So many crimes are committed daily in the name of devotion, allegiance, loyalty, that I have come to be skeptical about their worth and usefulness. Along the years, I gradually developed the gifts of tolerance and compassion. I discovered the healing and self-healing power of kindness and acceptance. I learned that we are all equal, despite our dissimilarities, and that we are all beautiful and rich because of our dissimilarities. I also learned that we always, always have something to give, even when we don't have much, and that something is the most precious gift of all: unconditional, undiscriminatory love. In short, I learned how to become a human being. Yes, I inherited a huge suitcase. I'm still unpacking it, getting rid of the superfluous, the unconvincing, the offensive, the inhumane. I'm still erasing the engraved words on that first page and trying to ink it with my own instead. At times, the process seems endless. Untangling the given from the chosen, the handed from the handpicked, the wanted from the inherited. It's a continuous, exhausting operation. But Wafa, my 11-year-old friend, is here. She's watching me with her sad eyes and distressed heart, making sure I don't stop. She's still gently asking me, "Joumana, will you be my friend? I won't quit until I deserve to be. Meanwhile, there's just one label that I need, that I want, that I accept, that I respect. Just one tag that is worth believing in and fighting for, and that I will keep doing my best to deserve more and better day after day. My name is Joumana Haddad, and I am not defined by being an Arab, nor Lebanese, nor an ex-Catholic, nor a working class member, nor a female, nor a feminist, nor feminine, nor an activist, nor divorced. What defines me